The lymphatic system is an important organ system. There are three main functions of the lymphatic system. Number one, to fight infection. Let's imagine for a minute that you have a bacterial infection, a systemic infection, meaning the bacteria are in your bloodstream. Those bacteria can get into the lymphatic system. So the really cool thing about having the lymphatic system is that those bacteria will pass through the lymph nodes, where the macrophages sit and wait to engulf those bacteria. The second function of the lymphatic system is to aid in fat absorption. Does this picture look familiar? It's been a long time, hasn't it? All right. So remember, once lipids are digested and absorbed into the epithelial cells lining the gut, they are reformed into a chylomicron, which then enters the lymphatic system and then into circulation. The third function of the lymphatic system is for fluid balance. Remember, homeostasis is the word. If the body cannot properly maintain fluid balance, you have edema. Edema is the excess fluid that is in the interstitial space. So there's lots of things that can cause this. You might have varicose veins, for example. If you have varicose veins, then you can have incompetent venous valves. So the venous valves don't function very well, and ultimately that can lead to edema. Pregnancy can also cause edema. Having the extra weight and gravity pushing everything down, so you can see pregnant women with cankles. Ankles, right, that are no longer because they're swollen. So it looks like part of their leg, hence the word cankle. Now, when we're talking about the lymphatic system, the terminology changes just a little bit, but it's a similar concept. In the lymphatic system, we call it lymphedema. You still have excess fluid, and it's still an excess of interstitial fluid. But now the cause is completely different. There's lots of things that can cause lymphedema. Lymphedema is caused by damage to the lymphatic vessels. Let's relate this to breast cancer. There are cases where women with breast cancer have a breast removed, and doctors also remove some lymph nodes in the axillaries, since that's the first place that breast cancer spreads to. By removing those lymph nodes, however, doctors can damage the lymphatic system. So then what winds up happening is lymphedema. These vessels are damaged, so the ventricles are not able to bring that fluid back into the venous system. So fluid accumulates in the area where the vessels have been damaged. In this case, in the axillary, which will cause the arm or parts of the arm to swell.